Привет всем, продолжаем выходить Fallout 4. Не забываем подписываться на мой канал, ставить лайки, оставлять комментарии. Всем заранее спасибо.
By Elder Maxon's orders, all forms of technology should be confiscated or collected.
What do you want?
The Brotherhood needs your help to protect the Commonwealth. Donate a portion of your crops to the Brotherhood, and it will not be forgotten.
Doesn't sound like we have much choice. We'll contribute our crops.
Don't let Ingram catch you standing around. You'll be on report before you can blink.
Attention, all personnel. I'm disappointed I need to address this, but unsanctioned social contact with Commonwealth natives is strictly prohibited. Anyone who is engaged in such fraternization should report to Knight Captain Cade for immediate decontamination. That is all.
Were you successful?
Yes, sir. Crops will be available when harvested.
I knew you'd be the right one for the job. Here are your caps, as per our agreement. Plenty of farms out there to cross off the list, if you're interested. If these farmers realize what we did for them on a daily basis, they'd be lining up to help.
Reporting for extra work.
You're just in time. I hear there's another farm just waiting for you to pay it a visit.
I'm in.
That's what I like to hear. You'll find the farm on your map. And don't forget, you get their cooperation by any means necessary.
If you're looking for ammunition or weapon mods, Proctor Teagan might have what you need. You'll get used to sleeping comfortably underneath massive containers of highly flammable gas.
It sounds like we owe you our gratitude for wiping out those monsters at Fort Strong. Now, did you have any documents for me? Or perhaps you were interested in aiding a research patrol?
I found some technical documents for you.
And they're in wonderful condition as well. Excellent work. Here are the caps that I promised. Remember, the Commonwealth is an almost unlimited source for these technical documents. Check every building you explore during your patrols very carefully, and you might be pleasantly surprised at what you find.
Brahmin with a vertebird. Now that's a challenge.
What do you want?
The Brotherhood needs your help to protect the Commonwealth. Donate a portion of your crops to the Brotherhood, and it will not be forgotten.
Donate? Haven't heard that one before. But raiders usually aren't that polite. Don't think I don't see what's going on here. You'll get your donation come harvest.
That's in better shape than I expected.
Hey, give me a minute.
Excuse me. Piper Wright, Public Occurrences.
So, are folks out here concerned with the Institute using synths to infiltrate the Commonwealth's food supply, possibly poisoning hundreds?
Gosh, I am now.
Oh, thank you for your time.
Nightera Aslan, Brotherhood of Steel, Recon Team 429 Alpha, serial number 3431. It's been 3 hours since I set my distress pulser. There's been no word from the Paladin or Ferris. Their objective was a satellite array on the coast. They may be out of range. My orders were to hold this position at all costs. The entire site has been overrun. The door won't last much longer. Paladin Brandis, sir. It's been an honor, sir.
Someone there! Brother! No!
This is normal for other journalists.
Garrett's up. Thank you.
You know what this place could use? Cover.
What's that? Nothing.
Goodness. Free for the taking. The lifts in Diamond City were fancy. How much of this do you think still works?
Heard some rumbles, this one didn't get you either. Figure I shouldn't be surprised.
Oh no, Shank. I died.
I'm a ghost.
Well, your secret's safe with me, regardless. So I suppose your recent success brings us to the next step. Loyalty. Without loyalty, everything that's yours ain't. And to keep a crew loyal, you need to keep them happy. Now, keeping raiders happy isn't real hard. Just have to make sure they've got their basic necessities, just like any other settlement. That they've got some things to keep them entertained, and that their food's taken care of, which, with raiders, well, isn't like dealing with other settlements. Now, if you want me to go into detail on any of that, you just say.
I want to know more about managing the outpost's basic necessities.
Day-to-day needs. They're pretty straightforward. Just need to make sure you've set up solid defenses. Plenty of beds under cover, and enough clean water to go around. Not much more to it than that. Was there anything else?
Tell me more about providing food for the outpost.
So, managing your outpost's food can get a little tricky. No one ever joined a crew to dig in the dirt, so you'll want to make sure you've convinced enough settlements to supply your gang. People at the outpost can farm in a pinch, but they sure as hell won't be happy about it. Now, if you're ever wondering if your outpost has enough food, you should take a look in your Pip-Boy. It ought to have a page that'll show you everything your outpost currently needs, food included. If they're low on grub, it's probably time to get a new settlement supplying you. Or you could always drop some food direct in their workshop if it comes to it. Now, was there something else?
What can you tell me about entertainment for the outpost?
Well, it's a damn handy way to keep folks distracted if you're lacking in certain basics. Constructing pick-me-up stations or getting one of your crew working on a booze still will certainly help lift your outpost's spirits. And if the place has got a Nuka World transmitter powered up, you can construct amplifiers to help as well. Anything else I can answer for you?
I think I've got everything I need to know.
Sure. If you've ever got more questions, you come find me. Or you can always consult that Pip-Boy on your arm. No better tool to tell you what your outpost may be hurting for. Now, depending on the state of the place when you hit it, this first outpost might already have some of the bare bones set up. All you've got to do is build up what's missing. If you want to run some jobs to convince more settlements to start sending supplies, well, you know how this works. You just come talk to me. And I was thinking, with the outpost coming as far as it has, might be time I set up shop there. Save you a trip anytime you want to run a job. You just let me know if that's something that'd interest you. Be good to make some trouble in the Commonwealth again. So, there anything I can do?
I want you to head to an outpost.
Yeah. Sure. Where am I going? Suppose I better get a move on then. See you there, boss.
handy, aren't ya?
Boss, what can I do for you?
Nothing for now.
All right.
hope all that tinkering leads to something.
Hey, Shank.
Look who it is. Got something for me?
Answer some questions for me.
Shoot.
Is there anything our outpost needs at the moment?
Actually, boss, sounds like you've got all the necessities taken care of. If outposts aren't getting to where you need them to be, you could try building some entertainment. Like a pick-me-up station, an amp and transmitter, or a booze still. So, was there something else?
That was it.
Got it. Something else I could do for you?
Nothing for now.
All right.
Need something, boss?
Hey, boss. Need something?
Looks like it's in working order.
Gotta chase what you wanna catch.
Can't talk right now. Gotta clean the Meyer Lurk scat off my boots.
That's it.
All the dangers of the wilderness, all the privacy of downtown.
Storytime Simon here with the exciting conclusion to The New Squirrel. Tomorrow we can get to know each other and become best friends, said Ricky to the Red Squirrel. The Red Squirrel made a sound that Ricky took for agreement, and the two squirrels curled up to sleep. Later that night, Ricky woke up to the sound of leaves rustling in the oak tree. He looked around. The Red Squirrel was gone. Ricky surveyed the landscape below and saw a pack of glowing eyes approaching the base of his tree. Cats! Ricky heard a voice from a nearby tree. It was the Red Squirrel. I'm sorry, he said. They were following me and I couldn't bring them to my tree. They would have eaten my family. As the cats ascended the tree and began to devour Ricky's friends and family, Ricky reflected on his decisions. His last words were, I really wish I would have trusted my elders. The end.
works direct to your doorstep. Lost him. Blue, we're not alone here.
Here to pick up a swatter.
Don't walk outside the wall undefended. High quality protection for sale.
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Who's our client?
A fisherman, whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
I'll go check it out. Thanks, Ellie.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
Ellie?
So, you find out where Earl Sterling ran off to?
Earl never went anywhere. Doc Crocker killed him during a botched surgery.
Crocker killed Earl? Gone as long as he was, I figured maybe Raiders or the Institute, but Crocker? Where's the doc now? Rotting in a cell, I hope.
It was either him or us. We had to put him down.
Goodness. I'm sorry you two had to go through that. Here, take this. Sounds like you earned it. I'll send word along. Let everyone down at the dugout inn know what happened. Shame it couldn't be better news. Thanks again for closing this one out. Be careful when you head over to the Nakano residence. That whole area is pretty isolated. I wonder what the story is between Mr. Nakano.
something.
What were you hiding? Nothing but garbage.
Sensitivity of my sensors clearly needs adjustment.
I think we found a new frontier of foul. Better in our hands anyway.
My scanners must be malfunctioning. Was in error. No enemy detected.
Detected.
appears to be nothing.
Must be imagining things.
Perhaps my sensors need celebration.
Your destruction.
By order of the Institute, you must be destroyed. You are damaging valuable Institute property. Initiated. Where did you go? Please come out. Gone. Excellent. Offline.
will end up someone else's dinner.
Yes.
Can't keep you out.
That's it.
Always on good behavior, aren't you?
There we go.
Certainly seems secure. Always on good behavior, aren't you? Always on good behavior, aren't you?
Got it.
Always on good behavior, aren't you?
I try to be.
Seems like you're doing better than trying. I appreciate it. Too few folks can be bothered, course, in my experience, if you want to do real good, playing nice only gets you so far.
I mean, look at Diamond City. A place I've been trying to warn of real danger. But every issue I publish, all I hear is, oh, Piper, why don't you ever publish anything happy? Piper, why can't you write something nice for a change? It's enough to make me want to hang up my hat some days.
Sounds like it must be exhausting.
No kidding. But people, they deserve to know the truth. Sure, it can be scary, knowing what's really out there. A night doesn't go by, I'm not afraid some Institute drone will decide today's the day to pay old Piper and family a visit. But it's worth it, because I know the truth. That's what protects us.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. How can you protect you and yours if you don't know what you're facing?
Exactly. Most folks, though, they'd prefer a comforting lie. Not me. I've seen firsthand what the truth can do. My sister and I, we grew up way out in the Commonwealth. Tiny little settlement. Our dad, he was part of the local militia. Keeping the raiders off our backs and the Mirelurks out of our latrines, as he'd describe it. Well, one day, our dad turns up dead. His captain, asshole named Mayburn, claims raiders must have gotten him on watch. Well, I didn't buy it. I start making inquiries. Turns out, the captain, he'd sold out. Thought he wasn't getting paid enough to babysit the town. He was gonna leave the gates open one night, let a group of raiders sack the place and take a cut of the profits. My dad found out and was gonna turn Mayburn in, but Mayburn got to him first. And I wasn't about to let that bastard get away with murder. I tried talking to the mayor, but he wouldn't listen. So, I papered the entire town in posters. Wanted for gross dereliction of duty, Captain Mayburn. The mayor sure wanted to talk after that. The town threw Mayburn out on his ass and were dug in when a very surprised group of raiders finally showed.
What happened after that?
We made do. Sis was still pretty young at the time, and Mom was out of the picture. So we got by on the kindness of others for a while. Eventually, I saved up enough to book us both passage with a caravan, and then we moved on up to the big city. Called it home ever since.
Piper. You saved those people.
No. Those people saved themselves. Because they knew the truth. But hey, I'm sorry if I've been rambling. I just get fired up sometimes. It's just nice to talk to someone who actually seems to get it, you know? So, should we head out? I guess no one will miss it at this point. place gives me the willies. Anyone decides to pick a fight with us out here, we're in trouble.
The sensitivity of my sensors clearly needs adjustment. Attacking enemy.
Hey, something's out there. This is normal for other journalists. I can carry something if you need me to.
You're mine now!
The checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently stocked with additional food, water, and ammunition.
Get some!
Yes, yes, we hear you.
This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens,
what?
Including non-military family members, will be turned away from matters of national safety.
it.
If you are in distress, please proceed to the South Boston Military Checkpoint for aid. Coordinates are available in your emergency handbook. This checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently stocked with additional food, water, and ammunition. This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens, including non-military family members, will be turned away for matters of national safety. This message will repeat.
Thank you.
Hey! You disappear! No fair!
Got it.
Ah, come out, come out! Wherever you are! Ah! You move too much! Sooner or later. Only one of us survives this. And it's...
Thank you. Establishing Mercer Safe House is a sign we're on the road to recovery. Thank you for that.
Pam wants to talk with you. She's in back.
I cleared out some Gen 1s for Randolph Safe House.
Randolph is still operational? Finally, some good news. We thought they were another casualty of the switchboard disaster. But Randolph's been dark for too long. It'll be controversial, but we have to put them under quarantine.
Is a quarantine really necessary?
It's possible the safe house has been replaced by Institute infiltrators. It's happened before. No. The smart move, the only move, is to keep them isolated until we know for certain. Our only communication with Randolph is going to be by dead drop. Check in periodically with Drummer Boy. He coordinates the dead drops for us. Thanks.
Up there, assume you're being watched. Always.
Bingo.
I'm a fan of Grognak myself. What will that wacky barbarian do next?
Human-machine interface set to 100%. Hello, Agent. I could use your help in acquiring another DIA cache.
I can recover it.
Location of cache being transmitted to your Pip-Boy. Conversation terminated.
Make sure you're never followed here. It's all our asses if you are.
You really walked the freedom trail. By yourself. Word is Diamond City is under opposition control.
explode! Stupid noises!
Picked on the wrong people today.
Going down. Second floor. Second floor. Going down.
Gonna splatter your brain! What's that? Human!
And they look mad! Of course they always look mad!
Ah, come out, come out! Wherever you are!
Hey.
Just let me know.
Thank you. Lost track of how many blisters I got.
Thank you. work site has gone 0 days without an incident.
Blue, we're not alone here. Found them and they do not look friendly.
fuck was that?
Pay for that!
Who's out there?
What was
coming
that?
There now.
Protectron on duty.
Come on,
get him down.
All is right there. Identified intruder detected. Beginning search.
Killed him!
Mr. Strelnikov, I know someone of your profession values discretion above all else. But I have to honestly say, screw that. I mean, come on. One bullet halfway across town, and you blew Ron Trevio's head clean off. You, sir, are an artist.
Attack on hostile target. Attention, citizens. You may now resume your normal activities.
What on earth could someone have done to deserve this?
Keep your eyes open. I think this asshole's using a stealth point. Having fun, huh?
How do you find anything in here?
Ну что ж, на этом пока что все. Продолжение следует. Не забываем подписываться на мой канал, ставить лайки, оставлять комментарии. Всем заранее спасибо.